Then came the blockade of Berlin. The Soviets cut the road and rail links to the city, isolating 2.25 million people. Overnight electric power from the Russian zone switched off. With these tactics, the Soviet expected to strangle the economic life of the Western sectors within weeks. But they had not counted on the Western allies. For months, everything to keep West Berlin alive, everything for the power plant was flown in. By fall of 1948, the structure was finished and ready to receive the machinery. But there was another long, harsh winter to be got through without lights. After nearly a year, the blockade was defeated. The nightmare was over. Now the way was free again. Trucks and trains were bringing food and supplies into the liberated city. Machinery for the electric plant no longer had to be flown in a piece at a time. The work of installing the machinery bought with Marshall Plan funds went ahead faster than ever.
Die augenblicklich höchste Leistungsfähigkeit der Luftbrücke festzustellen, unternahm das alliierte Luftbrückenkommando einen 24-stündigen Rekordeinsatz. Auf den Berliner Flugplätzen Tempelhof, Gatow und Tegel herrschte pausenloser Rekordbetrieb. In Abständen von rund 1,5 Minuten landeten die Flugzeuge. Mit Staunen sahen die an Überraschungen gewohnten Berliner diese bisher einzig dastehende Leistung in der Geschichte der Luftfahrt. In einer ununterbrochenen Kette von 1344 Flügen wurden 10.000 Tonnen Versorgungsgüter nach Berlin gebracht. Auf dem Rückflug wurden Berliner Exportwaren für die Westzonen mitgeführt. General Klee erklärte, der neue Luftbrückenrekord habe bewiesen, dass Berlin auf dem Luftwege mit wenigen zusätzlichen Flugzeugen ebenso versorgt werden könne wie vor der Blockade.
June 1948, 2.5 million people cut off, isolated from the outside world. The rooftops of Berlin. Chimneys line the sky in smokeless patterns. Mute testimony to the economic wall enclosing a shattered city. A wall over which airplanes are still flying, bringing food and coal on a 24-hour round-the-clock schedule. The people in the western sector of Berlin have learned to live with the sight and sound of these giant four-engine aircraft. For the past year, this has been their only hope. The only path open between Germany to the west and the landlocked island of Berlin. Today, one can read some doubt, some disillusionment in the faces of the men and women in the streets. A fear that any agreements reached at the conference between Washington and Moscow and London and Paris may not last. So what is our position in Berlin today? Brigadier General Frank L. Howley, American Commandant in Berlin and a member of the Allied Commandatura, the Four Power Control Board, explains it this way.
My factory was one of the first to close. Blockade meant no coal. No coal meant no electricity. And no electricity meant no work. Blockade meant something else, too. It meant no food. At least that's how it looked to us. Then things began happening at Tempelhof Airfield. The Americans, the British, the French had a different slant on this blockade. According to the press, they were going to supply Berlin by air. Well, you can't believe everything you read in the papers. Even after those first planes landed, we were kind of skeptical. Who ever heard of feeding 2.25 million people by air? but it meant a job for me. And that was the main thing then. What a job, too. About all I could say for it is, it was steady. A steady backache. On the day shift or the night shift, it didn't much matter. I guess I was beginning to feel a little sorry for myself.